So here at Goddard Space Flight Center, located in Greenbelt, Maryland, we are home to the world's largest organization of scientists and engineers. We do exciting work for mission, for science, and the four main disciplines of earth science, heliophysics, astrophysics, and planetary science.
We're really looking forward to what's going to come out of an exciting new program here at Goddard called the James Webb Space Telescope, which is the successor to Hubble, and it's going to look back even further into our universe and at higher resolutions.
So right here at NASA Goddard, we're building part of the structural heart of the James Webb Space Telescope that's going to house the science instruments. One of the challenges to building a telescope like this is it's really big. The sun shield is about the size of a tennis court. And of course, we don't have any rockets that are that big. So we have to build it so that it can be folded up and put in a rocket and launched, and then it deploys once it's in space.
The James Webb Space Telescope, which is one of our crown jewels, has a lot of exciting technologies. Technology we've been developing over the last decade or so.
We'll see the first stars and galaxies that formed in the very early universe. We're going to be able to study the atmospheres of extrasolar planets and just see lots of new things about the universe that we can't quite see yet. I think, you know, humans just innately have this questioning of where we came from and how we developed. And so the Webb Telescope in that sense is going to allow us to maybe catch a glimpse of origins as far as planet formation is concerned.
Goddard has a budget of about $2.9 billion, and it's been estimated that we have an economic return of a multiplier about 4 to 5 times that. That's money that's coming back into the Maryland economy that's being used for other purposes.
We have something called the Small Business Innovative Research Program, designed to award contracts for technology development to small businesses. We also do a lot of collaborations with small businesses in the areas if they have technology that may benefit NASA, and we're looking to bring it in and mature it so that NASA could use it, which also, you know, could lead to other business opportunities with NASA down the road. So we're always looking for ways to partner with small businesses and companies in the Maryland area.
Underpinning all of this, of course, is the innovation and technology that's enabling the missions, helping us further the capabilities of it, and taking the capabilities to whole new products out there in the economy.
For example, there was one case where some software that we use for the Hubble Space Telescope to tell where it's pointing is now being used to help track polar bears and whale sharks for conservation efforts. Kind of would replace the whole technology of putting tags on the shark or the polar bear, so it's less traumatic for them and it's actually more effective because the tags typically get lost. A company that licensed some software that was used to study ocean waves that's now using it to look at how the brain regulates blood flow people that have had spinal injuries or traumatic brain injuries so they can more effectively diagnose their situation.
So I actually grew up in Arkansas on a farm, and the skies were just gorgeous at night, and that's what got me interested in astronomy to begin with. And now to be working here at Goddard as a scientist, working on this new telescope that's going to be able to look back in the distant universe and see these first stars and galaxies, it really, you know, it's exciting for someone who came from a small rural town to be able to be involved in this groundbreaking technology.